Sairam children, welcome to maths class. Children, let us continue with our chapter number 6, division. Today we are going to learn long division method. Children, long division method is useful for dividing big numbers. Okay, in this first we write the division question and then we use multiplication tables to find the quotient. Now let us see how multiplication tables are used to solve the division questions. Let us see an example. Children, now look at this division example. Divide 72 by 9. Now the first step is to draw a division bracket. Okay, this is known as a division bracket. Okay, there is a line and there is a small bracket you can see here. This we have to draw first. Then the next step is to write the numbers in their proper place. Now inside the bracket you can see we have to write the first number, which is 72. 72 is our dividend. Number 72 is our dividend. Dividend is written inside. What is dividend? It is the number to be divided. Correct? So that we will write inside. Then 72 by 9. So number 9 we have to write here outside the bracket. Okay, number 9 is known as divisor. It is the number with which we divide. Correct? So here number 9 we have to write outside. Then after dividing, the answer that we will get, we have to write here up. Okay, so first we will find out what is the answer, then we are going to write up. So the answer is going to come here up, which is known as quotient. It is the result of division. Okay, children, I told you that for long division method we have to use multiplication tables. So how we are going to use multiplication tables, let us understand. Okay, now before using the multiplication tables, children, here you can see there are two numbers, 72, correct? Number 7 and number 2. First we will see number 7. Okay, now you can see the divisor, which is number 9, is a bigger number than number 7. Okay, while dividing you can take one number at a time, but you can see that number 9 is greater than number 7. Okay, so we cannot divide that. In such a case we have to take both the numbers together. Okay, we will take number 72 together. Got it, children? Now we have to find out in 9's table. Okay, now we have to see table of 9. In 9's table, do we have any number 72? Okay, so let us start saying 9's table, children. Come on, say with me. Come on. 9 ones are 9. 9 twos are 18. 9 threes are 27. 9 fours are 36. 9 fives are 45. 9 sixes are 54. 9 sevens are 63. And 9 eights are is 72. Children, so we have a number. Okay, exactly 9 eights are is equal to 72. Correct? So that means in 9's table 72 will go. Okay, we can divide number 72 into 8 equal parts. Correct? So how we are going to write? We will write number 8 here up, okay, and then we will write here 72. Okay, 9 multiplied by 8 is equal to 72. Got it, children? Okay, so 9 eights are is 72, right? So we'll write here number 8 up, 9 eights are 72. Now children, the next step is subtraction. Here you can see we have got these two numbers. Okay, these two numbers we have to subtract. So it is minus 72. Okay, put a line, put a dash here and then subtract. 2 minus 2 is 0, 7 minus 7 is 0. Okay, so 9 8s are 72. And this 0, 0 children, it is known as remainder. Okay, so our remainder is 0. Got it, children? 8 is our quotient. It is our answer. So, we can say 72 divided by 9 is equal to 8. Children, here in the earlier we have seen that there was no answer, right? So, 8 is our answer, which is known as our quotient. Children, now take out your textbook and your notebook. We are going to start with exercise 6.5 and we are going to solve few sums related to long division method. Okay, here in exercise 6.5 question number 1, basically all the questions are related to multiplication tables. Okay, so first of all you have to learn all the multiplication tables. It is very very important. Okay, otherwise you will not be able to do multiplication or division. Got it? So take out your notebook, children. Right, exercise 6.5, question number 1, divide using multiplication tables. A1 is 36 divided by 9. Our children, first of all, our first step is to draw the bracket. Okay, so I'm going to draw your bracket like this. Then the first number, which is the dividend, it will go inside 36. Okay, then the divisor I have to write here outside, number 9. Okay, so in 9's table I have to find out whether I have number 36 or not. So what I will do, let us say 9's table. Come on, children. 9 1's are 9, 9 2's are 18, 9 3's are 27, 9 4's are 36. Correct? So we have number 36. So 9 multiplied by 4 is equal to 36. Correct, children? Now how we are going to write it down? See, 9 is given here. It is our divisor. 9 multiplied by 4. 4 will come here up. Okay, it is our answer. 9 4s are 36. Okay, in this way we have to write 9 4s are 36. And this we have got, this we have to subtract. Put a subtraction sign, then put a dash. Okay, now 36 minus 36 is 0. Right, so 0 is our remainder. And what is our quotient? 4. So 36 divided by 9 is equal to 4. Understood, children? Easy it is. Come on, note it down in your notebook. This sums we have to do in the notebook. Okay children, next one is B1, 64 divided by 8. Okay, so first draw the bracket. Right, dividend divided by divisor, which is number 8. Okay, now 8's table, you have to think, do I have number 64? Yes, I have number 64. What times 8? 8's are 64. Correct, children? So I will write here 8. 8's are 64. Okay, put a subtraction sign, put a dash, and then subtract it. 64 minus 64 will be 0. Correct? So my answer is number 8. So answer you note it down. So 64 divided by 8 is equal to 8. Now see sum, 60 divided by 6. Okay, now children, see in A sum and B sum. Okay, it was 36 divided by 9 and 64 divided by 8. Correct? The first number was smaller than the divisor. So we took two numbers together. But in this case, you can see that the first number is number 6. Okay, it is not smaller, it is equal to. Right? So what we have to do in such a case? First, we will draw the bracket. Okay. Then we will write the dividend 60 divided by 6. Now here we are going to take one number at a time. First we will take number 6. In 6 table, will this number 6 go? Yes, it will go. It will divide. By what? 6 ones are is 6. Correct? So we will write here 6 ones are 6. Okay? Put a subtraction sign and then subtract it. 6 minus 6 is equal to 0. Now here you can see there is one more number remaining, which is 0. This number will come down. Okay, the next step is the next number will come down. 0. Got it, children? Now this 0 is very important. Okay, you have to divide that 0 also. Okay, how we are going to do it? See, children, in multiplication table, okay, 6 into 1 is equal to 6. But 6 multiplied by 0 is equal to 0. This also we have. So directly we can write 6 zeros are, 0 will come here, zeros are 0. Okay, and then subtract it. 0 minus 0 is 0. Okay, now children, here you can see the answer is number 10. Got it, children? Or this is one way. Otherwise, you can do it directly also. 60 divided by 6. Okay. In 6 table, you can see whether 60 will come or not. At what times it will come, children? 6 tens are is 60, right? 6 tens are is equal to 60. Okay. So, directly 6 tens are minus 60. 0. This also you can do it. Children, but I want you to copy this method, okay, because in our question number 2, this type of sums are also there. So please go through it and write this one. Note it down, children, in your notebook. Okay, children, now D question. In D question, we have 24 divided by 4, okay. So let us make the bracket. 24 is the dividend, we will write it inside, divided by 4. Okay, in 4 table we have to check whether 24 will go or not, right? Now why, children, see the children, but first see the first number, it is number 2, it is smaller than 4, correct? So we have to take both the numbers together in this case. So that is why we will check in 4th table 24 will go or not, correct? So in 4th table, in how many times it will go? 4, 6 are 24, correct? So 4, 6 are 24, okay? Put your minus sign and then subtract. 24 minus 24 is equal to 0. So our answer is number 6. Note down, children, in your notebook. Easy, children, it is. Next one is E question. 35 divided by 7. Children, this sums I have done it directly. Let us see. First, may draw the bracket, write the dividend and the divisor. Okay. In 7's table, here we have to check when 35 will go. Okay. When it will go? 7 5's are 35. Correct, children? 7 into 5 is equal to 35. Right, children? It is 5's are. So what I will do? I will write your number 5 up. Okay. 7 5's are 35. Then we have to put your subtraction sign and we will subtract. 35 minus 35 is equal to 0. So our answer is number 5. So 35 divided by 7 is equal to 5. Next one is F1. 40 divided by 5. Right, children? First draw the bracket and write number 40 inside. It is our dividend. divided by 5. Divisor we have to write here out. Now in 5's table we have to see when 40 will go. 5 what's a 40? 5 8's a 40, right? So number 8 we will write here up. 5 8's a 40. Okay, put your subtraction sign and then subtract. Which numbers we are going to subtract? These two numbers, 40 minus 40, which is equal to 0. So our final answer we will write as, so 40 divided by 5 is equal to 8. This is our answer. Number 8 is our answer. It is our quotient. Note down, children, in your notebook. Next question is G1, 18 divided by 2. Okay. Now 2's table, it is very easy. First, draw the bracket. Write number 18, children, here inside and number 2 here outside. Okay. It is our divisor. In 2's table, when 18 will go, 2 9's are 18. Correct. So number 9, we have to write here up in place of quotient. 2 9's are 18. You can see it goes always like this. 2 9's are, and here we will write the 18. 2 9's are 18. Okay. So we will put a subtraction sign. 18 minus 18 is 0. Okay. So our answer is 18 divided by 2 is equal to 9. Next one is H sum. 48 divided by 6. Okay, children, write 48 inside the bracket and number 6 here out. Okay, 6 what's a 48? 6 8's a 48. Correct, 48 will go in 6 table. So, we will write it directly. 6 8's a 48. 8 will come here up because it is our answer, our quotient. 6 8's a 48. Then put your subtractions and don't forget to put the subtraction sign, it is important. 48 minus 48 is equal to 0. Okay. So, 48 divided by 6 is equal to 8. Got it, children? The sums are very easy and interesting also. Now, it's time for homework. There are only 4 questions, children, from question number 1. Divide using multiplication tables. I, J, K and L sum you are going to do in your homework notebook. Got it, children? Thank you, students. Bye-bye.